Sound is always on. You even perceive it when you are asleep. We ignore a lot of sounds unconsciously, but it still influences our mood and our behavior. We can choose to listen to sound, but sometimes sound just takes over. And if you would record your daily life environment in sound and listen back afterwards, you will hear more and different things, things you didn't notice when you were actually there. I found that fascinating, and that what intrigues me and makes me curious about sound. My name is Vincent Koning. I'm the co-founder of Big Orange. We are a music and post-production studio based in the Netherlands. We've got 5 studios and 2 recording rooms in 2 locations, Utrecht and Amsterdam. And we are specialized in music composition and audio post-production for documentaries, and we make immersive audio experiences for museums and brands. Here in Big Orange, we do not have one particular type of audio production, but we are specialists in creating audio experiences from concept to production to the final product. And it goes from installed sound to sound objects to tour guides in different languages to podcasts and VR. Audio for VR is very important because if there's a disconnect between audio and visuals, you cannot speak of an experience. So it has to be spot on, and that's very difficult to have it spot on, to create a sound environment with visuals to it, because there's a lot of things you don't see but you have to hear, because you don't know where the viewer is going to look at. Some viewers will look at that direction, and in the same shot, some people will look at that direction. And everything has to be important, but if sound gets too important, it will distract you from the actual story. So that's a really difficult thing to do.
Even now, my dad's dead. You can't keep your eyes on my dead dad. Are you fucked?
One big VR project we did was the first stereoscopic 360 live action VR movie in the Netherlands. It's called Ashes to Ashes. For Ashes to Ashes, we did all the audio post-production and music composition. And we had to face a lot of challenges. It was our first major VR project. It was head-tracked, it was stereoscopic, sounds were close by and far away. How are we going to record sound on a set where you cannot be there as a sound guy? So we had to hide microphones. How were the actors moving around the camera? So we took a camera to the ceiling and recorded the walking lines of the people. And then the biggest challenge was the audio post-production. The software we were running at that time wasn't capable of doing VR projects, so we had to look for a new DAW, and we came to Nuendo. Our first encounter with Nuendo was our biggest project and most difficult project ever. We wanted a DAW which was suitable for good music composition and outstanding capabilities of audio post-production. Nuendo has it both, so we've tested it on that project, and during the project we encountered so many advantages which we didn't use for that project but we could use in different projects which were running at that time. We were so enthusiastic that after the project we swapped DAWs and we bought 6 licenses. So now every studio is equipped with Nuendo. We also have the Nuage, which improves our workflow even better. But to be honest, it's also much more fun to work with. The full integration, I can dive in much deeper in the software. I can be much more creative. In the future, I hope Nuendo will continue to develop as they have done before. With every new major release, there are new major features which improves our creativity, our workflow. We're confident that with Nuendo we are up to date, and that Nuendo will keep us providing the right tools for our future projects.